directly with the problems of number system, first let's understand what are the important formulae which are required in order to solve number system problems. Okay, so first important rule is, let's see what are the numbers divisible by 2. In order to know the numbers which are divisible by 2, the numbers units place should be having either 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay. If any numbers units place is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, then the number will be divisible by 2. Okay. Example, the question is 1, 2, 4, 6, 8 divisible by 2? Okay, so this is the question. Is 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 12,468 number is divisible by 2 or not? We know this is called units place. Okay. If the units place of the number has any of these digits, either 0, 2, 4 or 6 or 8, then it means that the number is divisible by 2. Okay, so in units place of 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, we have 8 as the units place. So the number is divisible by 2. Like this, we can easily solve the problem. Let's see what is the rule where we can find out whether the given number is divisible by 3 or not. Okay, now let's learn the rule. If sum of the digits of given number is divisible by 3, then the number also will be divisible by 3. Okay, this is the rule. If the sum of the digits of the given number is divisible by 3, then the number also will be divisible by 3. For example, question is 1, 2, 3 is divisible by 3 or not? Okay, this is the question. 1, 2, 3, the number 1, 2, 3 is divisible by 3 or not? We need to find out the sum of the numbers. As we have just found, we need to find out the sum of the numbers. 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6. Okay, we need to see whether the final output is divisible by 3 or not. 6 is divisible by 3. As the sum of numbers is divisible by 3, the whole number is also divisible by 3. Okay, so now let's see what is the rule where we can find the number which is divisible by 4. Okay, if the last two digits of a number is divisible by 4, then the complete number will also be divisible by 4. Okay, now let's see an example. For example, 1, 2, 2, 4, we need to find out whether the number 1, 2, 2, 4 is divisible by 4 or not. Okay, this is the question. Now what we need to do is, as we know the rule, we need to see whether the last two digits are divisible by 4 or not. What are the last two digits? 24. 24 is divisible by 4. So the conclusion is whole number. So when the last two digits of a number is divisible by 4, see, the last two digits of the number is 24. 24 is directly divisible by 4. So now we can directly say that 1, 2, 2, 4 is also divisible by 4. Okay. Now let's see the rule for finding out whether the number is divisible by 5 or not. This is very easy. If the unit digit of a number has either 0 or 5, then we can understand that the number, the complete number, is divisible by 5. Okay, for example, let's see the problem is 1, 2, 8, 6, 5. Okay, now in question they are asking to find out whether 12865, the number 12865, is divisible by 5 or not. Now what we need to do is, we need to check with the units place of the digit. This is called the units place of the digit. The units place should be either 5 or 0, okay? So we have 5 in units place. So we understood that the entire number of 12865 is also divisible by 5, okay? Now let's see what is the rule to understand that the number is divisible by 6 or not. What is the rule? If the given number is divisible by both 2 and 3, okay, the given number should be divisible by 2 as well as 3. If that rule satisfies, then we can conclude that given number is also divisible by 6, okay. The important rule is it should be divisible by both 2 and 3. Now let's see an example in order to check whether the given number is divisible by 6 or not, okay. So the example is 228, okay. 228 is the number which we took an example. We need to check whether the given number is divisible by 2 or not, okay. So what is the rule for divisibility of 2? It should either have 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 in its unit place. First, let's check it. In units place, there is 8. So, first rule satisfied. The number is divisible by 2. Now, let's see whether it is divisible, whether the same number is divisible with 3 or not. What is the rule for 3? We need to get the sum of the digits. Okay. 2 plus 2 plus 8. What is the solution? It is 12. 12 is divisible by 3. We already know 12 is divisible by 3. So, the given number 228 is divisible by 2 as well as 3. So, now we can conclude that the given number is also divisible by 6. Okay. Now, let's see what is the rule to check whether the given number is divisible by 8 or not. Okay. So, if the last 3 digits of a number is divisible by 8, then the whole number, the given number entirely also will be divisible by 8. This is the rule. Now let's see an example. Example 25576. Okay. So now this is the given number and we are asked to find whether the given number is divisible by 8 or not. Okay. So now what we need to do? We need to check the last 3 digits of the number. What are the last 3 digits of the number? It is 576. 576 is divisible by 8. So, as the last 3 digits of a number is divisible by 8, then the whole number 25576 also will be divisible by 8. Okay. So, now let's see what is the rule to check whether the number is divisible by 9 or not. Okay. If the sum of the number is divisible by 9, then we can say that the full number will also be divisible by 9. Okay. So now let's see an example. Okay. 64575. We are asked to find whether the number 64575 is divisible by 9 or not. Now what we need to do? We need to add this number. We need to find the sum of these digits. 6 plus 4 plus 5 plus 7 plus 5, which gives us 27. Now the sum of the digits is 27, which is easily divisible by 9. So this 64575 number is also divisible by 9. Like this we need to check. Okay. So now let's see what are the 3 most important formulae in order to solve any kind of series problems. Okay, number series problems. So first important formula is, whenever they are giving the number in the form of 1 plus 2 plus 3, so on up to n in this series, then the formula for this is half into n into n plus 1. Okay, whenever we are asked to find the solution for 1 plus 2 plus 3, so on up to n series, then we can directly use this formula, half into n into n plus 1. Okay, so when they gave 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square, so on up to n square, in order to solve the square number series, we need to use 1 by 6 into n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1. This is the formula. Okay, if they gave cube series, 1 cube plus 2 cube, so on up to n cube. If this is the case, then we need to use the formula 1 by 4 into n square into n plus 1 whole square. These three are the most important formula coming to number series. So now let's start solving the common problems, which will be mostly repeated in the exam. Okay, so now coming to first most important problem. They gave us the product of the two numbers. They are saying the product of the two numbers is 9375. Okay, when we are dividing the larger number with the smaller number, the answer we are getting is 15. We are getting quotient as 15. Okay, now they are asking what is the sum of the numbers. I am explaining you the question again. They are saying the product of two numbers is 9375, and when the larger number is divided by the smaller number, the quotient is 15. Now they are asking us to find what is the sum of the number. Okay, so now let's start solving the problem. First, let's think. Let the numbers be x and y. Okay, so they are saying the product of two numbers, right? So let the numbers be x and y. Now what they are doing, they gave the product of the two numbers as 9375. When we took the product of two numbers, the result is 9375. Okay, the product of two numbers is 9375. So we are just multiplying x and y, which gives us xy, and the product we already know, which is 9375. Okay, now the quotient when divided by larger to smaller number is 15. Now we are dividing both the numbers in order to get the quotient as 15. Okay, so x divided by y, we are dividing both the numbers, which gave us quotient as 15. Okay. Now let's think. This is statement 1. This is statement 2. Now we just need to solve these two statements in order to get the sum of the number. Okay. First, we assume that the two numbers are x and y, and then the product of x and y is 9375, and when we divide, the quotient is 15. We did x by y, which gave us the quotient 15. Now we are solving these two statements in order to get the final result. We need to solve using both these statements. This is statement 1 and this is statement 2. Now we are solving using both these statements. Okay, I'm taking left hand side of statement 1 and dividing it with left hand side of statement 2. This is left hand side of statement 1 and left hand side statement 2. Okay, so repeat the same process with the right hand side also, which gives us 9375 divided by 15. What we are doing is we are just dividing product of numbers with division of numbers in the left hand side, and in right hand side we are just dividing the result of this. Okay, so now we need to solve this statement. 15 into xy is equal to 9375 into x by y. Just solve this, then we will get y square is equal to 625. And y is equal to root of 625, which gives us 25. So now we got the value of y. So here we got to know the value of y, which is 25. Now we are substituting y value in this statement. X by y is equal to 15. In place of y, we already know the value of y is 25. So x by 25 is equal to 15. And 25 goes to right hand side. X is equal to 15 into 25, which gives the answer as 325. Okay, now we know the value of x as well as y. X value is 375 and y value is 25. And the question is, they are asking us to find what is the sum of two numbers. Okay, so now what we need to do is we need to find x plus y. So x plus y is, x is 375 plus y is 25, which gives the answer as 400. So the ultimate answer is x plus y is equal to 400 is the question. So the sum of two numbers is 400. The next question is, this is also one of the most commonly repeated questions from numbers system. So the question is, there are 20 people in a party, and if every person shakes hand with each other person, what are the total number of handshakes? This is the question. Okay, so there in a party there are 20 people, 20 people in a party, and they shaked hands with each other person. Now we are asked to find what are the total number of handshake. Now let's solve the problem. So let's see. First person will shake hand with 19 people. Second person will shake hand with 18 people, because first person will be busy with shaking hands with people. Okay. Third person will shake hand with 17 people. First person will shake hand with 19 people. Second person will shake hand with 18 people, and third person will shake hand with 17 people. Like this, the count gets reducing. Why? Because when first person is giving shake hand, second person can't go and give shake hand to first person because he's already busy with shaking hand with few other people. That's why the count gets reducing like this. Now let's see how to solve this problem. So now it is nothing but series, decreasing, reducing series of numbers. So 19 plus 18 plus 17 plus, so on up to 1. Okay, we need to find out the summation of series of 19 to 1. As the number of people are in reducing order, we need to take the decreasing order series, 19 plus 18, so on up to 1. So this also can be written as summation of 19. Summation of 19 is in the format of summation of n, which can be written as n into n plus 1 by 2, and we already know the value of n. So instead of n, we are substituting 9 and solving, which gave us the result 190. So now let's see next important question. If the position of digits of two numbers is interchanged, the number obtained is smaller than the original number by 27. If the digits are in the ratio of 1 is to 2, then what is the original number is the question. Okay, he's saying there is two digit number, and if the digits are interchanged, we get another number, right? So the interchanged value is 27, less than the original number. Okay, it is smaller than the original number, and the difference between these both is 27. If the digits of the number is in the ratio of 1 is to 2, then he is asking us to find out the original number. So now let's think. Original number is 10x and y. So you may get doubt why instead of taking x and y, I took 10x and y. This is in ones place, units place, and this is in tens place. So that's why I took as 10x. The original number is 10x and y. Okay, he is saying when the two digits are interchanged, so 10x and y are interchanged, which becomes 10y and x, and the difference of the digits is 27. Now we need to solve this statement. Okay, 10x plus y minus 10y is equal to 27. I just did nothing. I just interchanged the places of these digits, interchanged the values. Okay, so 10x became 10y, y became x, and their difference is already given in the question as 27. Now when we solve this, we'll get 9 into x minus y is equal to 27. So which gives the answer, x is equal to 2 by y. Okay, so now we know the value of x. X is 2 by y. So now we'll get the statement x minus y is equal to 3. Okay, so when we solve this, 9 on 2, x minus y is equal to 27, we'll get the statement x minus y is equal to 3. Okay, so now what is he saying? He's asking us to think the digits of the number is in the ratio 1 is to 2. Okay? That is, y is to x is equal to 1 is to 2. Let's just think, okay? So it can be also written as y by x is equal to 1 by 2. It can also be written as y by x is equal to 1 by 2. So when we solve this, we'll get x is equal to 2y, okay? So now when we solve this statement, we'll get x is equal to 2y. Now we know x is equal to 2y. Now what we need to do is we need to substitute x is equal to 2y into this statement. We are substituting x is equal to 2y. We got to know the value of x. So 2y minus y is equal to 3. So y is equal to 3. So we know the value of y. See, we are doing nothing. We got the value of x. We are substituting the x value in this statement. Okay, in this statement, x minus y is equal to 3. X is equal to 2y. We know this. So we are just substituting this in this statement. X minus y is equal to 3. X value is 2y. 2y minus y is equal to 3. So we'll get the value y as 3. Okay, so now if we substitute y value in the same statement, x minus y is equal to 3. X minus 3 is equal to 3. So x is equal to 3 plus 3, which is 6. So we got the value of x also, which is 6. So now we know the value of x and y. Okay, x is equal to 6, y is equal to 3. So the original number is 6, 3. Like this, we need to solve the problem. So now let's see the next question. In this question, he is asking, there are two numbers, okay? So sum of twice of first number and thrice of second number is 100. We'll solve simultaneously so that we can understand the question better, okay? So solution. So first, what is he saying? He's saying sum of twice of first number and thrice of second number is 100. Let's think the numbers are x and y. Let's first think the numbers are x and y. Now what is he saying? Sum of twice of first number. Sum of twice of first number means what is twice of first number? It is 2x plus he is saying sum. So we wrote plus and thrice of second number. What is thrice of second number? Second number is y. Thrice of second number is 3y. Okay, 3 into y is 3y. Is 100. So sum of twice of first number and thrice of second number is 100. This, so now we solve it till here. Now let's see what is the second part of the question. Okay, now he is saying sum of thrice of first number. Again, forget sum of for few seconds. Thrice of first number. What is thrice of first number? 3x. Now see, sum of, so put plus and till here we solved. Now twice of second number. What is twice of second number? Second number is y. Twice of second number is 2y. Is 120. So that's what he is saying. Okay, so now what is he asking? What is the larger number? Now he is asking us to find. So now he is asking us to find what is the larger number. This is very easy problem. Now we got two equations, right? Let's think this is equation one and this is equation two. Once we solve both the equations, we'll get the values. Okay, x is equal to 32. Y is equal to 12. What we need to do is we just need to solve these both. That's it. So yeah, friends, I hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching the video till the end. And this is just the part 1 video of number system. Part 2 video of number system is going to come this week itself. So make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends to support our channel so that we can bring more and more useful and helpful videos for you people. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel.